first man through to the final. Who will it be? Azizpour of Iran, Chaves of Brazil. High kick early on from Azizpour.
There's that front kick I was talking about. That's the one. Nice little jab thrown out by, you know, Bruno. Bruno's got to be a little bit more active here. He doesn't want to allow, you know, Iraj to start getting off, especially with those kicks.
Solid low kick, nice trajectory there from Chaves. Chaves got the height on him. Thrusts out the jab, does the Brazilian, both in orthodox stance. A little lighter on the feet is Azizpour.
Nice body kick landed by Iraj. Chaves says that yes, Iraj has a very iron chin, but he's hittable. His head stays in the middle, and he's able to find a home for those big punches. And he's got to be a little bit more active here.
Azizpour has already beaten one Brazilian in one Super Series, that being Anderson Silva. Inside leg kick, nice and high to that femoral profunda from Chaves.
Trade leg kicks, nice little feint there from Bruno. He was able to get a reaction out of Iraj.
Chaves was training over there in Thailand alongside Alistair Overeem, former K1 World Grand Prix champion.
Iraj tried that redirection with the forearm.
Inside leg again from Chaves.
I like that defense from Iraj.
Cerebral fight so far from Bruno Chaves, but his coach, Nick Hemmers, did say he can swing either way. He can be cerebral or he can be a brawler. Overhand there from Azizpour.
And to start from both these guys, they're just kind of throwing out one shot at a time. Ooh, and that one was a little bit low.
Azizpour may be auditioning for the Iranian boys choir after that one. We'll get some recovery time here, Iraj. What do you think so far of Bruno Chaves, seeing him in one for the first time, Dragon?
He's relaxed, he's composed, he's shown us the high level experience that he's bringing into the circle here tonight. He looks comfortable. You know, he's trying to show us a little bit of some of the stuff that he's known for. He's putting those hands together, but everybody's just kind of trading one shot. You know, I go throw one, you throw one. And they're just sort of downloading information at this point. They know that one shot can end the match, so they're both being very careful.
High kick from Chaves, nicely done off the lead leg, no switch on it, smiles it as it's poor. Anything you can do, I can do just as well.
This is what Chaves likes to do. He likes to let people come forward and sort of throw shots so he can figure out how to counter those shots.
I want round here. Getting high off both legs here is Iraj Azizpour. Trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck, goes the inside thigh. Nice long reach on the left hand there from Iraj. Downstairs goes Chaves. You can see the reddening under the left arm, courtesy of those right round kicks on the body of Chaves.
That's what I like to see from Chaves. He puts hand combinations together and then he throws the low kick. And I like that low kick just to sort of slow some of the movement coming from Iraj. Right now, Iraj is the one dictating where this match is taking place.
Solid right hand to the jaw there from Chaves. We have three judges circle side scoring on a 10-point must system. Who's going to win the first round? Chaves looking for a brawl on the inside. And we go to the towel.
Interesting first round. Chaves started to pick things up there in the later half, but Iraj was able to land some kicks, do a little bit of damage, got some good reads. Let's see what kind of adjustments are made.
You want water on your head? Let me bring guys. Deep, deep breath. Deep breath. Relax yourself and just hit it.
More. The right punch is good. You are too strong and too good, but work.
If you give him with a low kick, he cannot do anything anymore. Just throw the low kick, okay?
First low kick was very good, bro.
Hands high and low.
Be sharp.
And there he is, Nick Hemmers, the brother of the late, great Ramon Decker, telling Bruno Chaves leg kicks all night long. Good advice, I feel, Dragon. The leg kicks of Chaves are fantastic.
Yeah, and they're super fast, and I like the way they're behind the punches. That's what I want to see from Chaves. Put those hand combinations together and then start throwing the leg kicks. Get Iraj to start thinking about something else besides just those hand combinations.
Overhand right from Azizpour, going for the cranium cracker. Launches it again, does the Iranian.
Up, up, up! Stop!
Iraj is trying to go forward now, trying to be a little more active.
The corner of Iraj, or corner of Chaves, I should say, is saying, Bruno, go first, you've got to go first. They want him to establish dominance here, establish authority in the second round.
big shots, throwing huge overhand rights, big kicks, trying to put him out with one shot. Chavez needs to put combinations together, especially that jab. When Iraj starts to run in, start throwing that jab out there, and then land that big right hand.
Fist for the right to fight either Roman Kriklia or Guto Innocente in the final of the Heavyweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. As his pull takes a groin strike.
You good?
Right.
You good? Keep you clean, all right? Keep you clean. Good.
Getting vocal here. Referee the boss, Olivier Cost. Right hand ready. There it goes. Again from Azizpour, but he telegraphed it. Chavez calling him forward. Chavez likes to sit, as we say, usually against the ropes, here against the fence. Overhand right from the Brazilian.
There's the right hand, but I'd like to see him throw something behind it and then something after it.
Fake there from Chavez. Overhand right to a high left round kick from Azizpour.
Now Azizpour is trying to put combinations together.
Stop, break, break.
The flexibility of Azizpour for a man of this size is quite impressive. Corner of Chavez are shouting out, we need combinations. We need you to go first here, Bruno. He goes to the outside leg, spins around quickly. No counter there from Iraj. Iraj goes body. Thought he might have gone upstairs with that lead leg. Overhand right, telegraphed it again.
Center, center, center.
Doesn't want
to. Guys.
Any words. Doesn't want to go to the well one time too many with that overhand right. As his core or Chavez is really going to get a read on it.
Nice lead leg front kick. Sure swept out. Chavez took him off balance. Iraj is definitely going for big shots right here. Everything he's throwing with is maximum power. Bruno's trying to put combinations together, trying to bait him in, trying to draw something out.
Corner telling Bruno, we've got 20 seconds to go. Finish strong. We want leg kicks here. But it's Azizpour that goes to the legs. Now the leg kick. Azizpour counters upstairs with a punch.
10 seconds.
Corner calling up the time. Azizpour goes upstairs. Bruno shakes his head, says they've got to do better than that. Two rounds down, one to go.
I really think this match is going to come down to activity. Who can just be a little bit more active? Because right now there seems to be holding something back. Right? Big right hand. Nice little fake, though, on that right hand. Like he cocked it, he loaded it, he pulled the trigger, hesitated just momentarily, and then threw it. Big weapons coming from Iraj. And Bruno's just not firing.
You're losing. You're not doing nothing. Work now. Fight. You need to knock him out now, okay?
Fight for your family, bro.
Work now. Everything now.
Everything you have to do is only a low kick.
Fight. I want to see power now. You fight now.
Why do you get into the clinch? Active clinch. No defensive clinch, okay?
Hey, I'm here. You fight now. You want to win or not? Not time. Fight now.
Fucking low kick, man.
Yeah, you
see,
yes.
Hey. Chavez. Getting a couple of slaps there from his trainer, Nick Hemmers, trying to wake him up, telling Bruno in no uncertain terms, you're losing. You are losing. We need to win this. You need to knock him out. Can Chavez answer the call of his corner? Third and final round.
Let's see who picks it up here in the third. I mean, you think he's right? Has Iraj 1-2? Oh.
Can Chavez go first?
Go whip, what? Let's go whip.
See, that big right hand is so telegraphed. He comes from his pocket all the way back. It's like he's trying to throw a baseball into the cheap seats up here in the Singapore Indoor Stadium. But then that is, you know, Bruno's opportunity to really capitalize. He's got to do something on those big misses.
Bruno's corner sitting right next to us here, Ed, begging for him to work, to go first. They are pleading with him. But it's Azizpour again. Oh, high kick! Beautifully done! And Bruno felt that one. That's why he called him forward. He felt it. Maybe that'll wake him up.
And he engaged a ball with Iraj. That's his best combination. Michael. He throws that right hand, leads himself right into that left high kick.
Can he make this a brawl with 2 minutes to go? Azizpour calling him forward.
See, Iraj wants him to make him go first, right? He's trying to get him to bait him in so he can counter, but Bruno's just not firing. So Iraj is forced to go first and trying to initiate something.
Nick Hemmer saying, you start, Bruno, you start, go first. Don't be afraid. And he backs off again.
But again, that's what Iraj wants, so why would he play into what his opponent wants him to do?
Because what he's doing at the moment is
isn't working for him.
This is true. He has to go first, and then he has to go last.
He needs a complete 180. Guys, he's not going first. He's sitting back. He needs to go first. Listen to his corner.
Iraj just waved his touchery.
He did too. Turning back kick there from Iraj. Thought about it again. He is inside the mind of Chaves right now. He is way deep inside the mind.
Yeah, he's having fun out there. Look how relaxed and look at him. See? He's just comfortable and having fun out there.
He's playing mind games, almost mocking him, and it's having an effect on Chaves. Chaves is buying into it. Inside leg kick, but no hands over the top from Bruno Chaves. Azizpour constantly smiling at him, grinning at him.
But we've seen this before. The first time athletes come to one championship, they're kind of overwhelmed. You know, the bright lights, the camera.
Spinning hook kick, did you see that?
Yeah, he's from a big showman, man.
Hook kick. What a show from Iraj. But you're at Dragon, it's a whole different ball game when you step up into the world's largest martial arts organization to the highest levels in the world against the best on the planet. It's all different to what Chaves is used to.
Yes. And Iraj is comfortable with it. He's been at home here. This is his third matchup, and he's looking really calm. There's another one of those hook kicks.
A man of this size should not be able to spin with that agility.
Yeah, but it also takes a little bit of time, too. You know, it shaves a few seconds off at the clock when you throw that, and then you have to get back up.
We are going down to the judges. Will it be Iraj Azizpour, or will it be Bruno Chaves to take on the winner of Cricklier or Innocente in the finals? Iraj confident. How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, 1-1-61, Pit Morakot versus Talon Chai. This has been semi-final number one of the Heavyweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. Disappointment in the face there of Bruno Chaves. Jubilation in the Iranian corner. Nick Hemmer's telling his charge before the third round. You've got to knock him out, Bruno. You are losing. Ever seen a happier fighter? Somebody who smiles more than Iraj Azizpour. He epitomizes joy. He epitomizes pleasure and happiness in fighting. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Iraj Azizpour!